Avalanche in Colorado.
Unbelievable. Yeah. That one, I know that we saw earlier on I-70 mm-hmm. where the snow just wiped cars right. off the road was crazy. Here we're talking about much, much less snow
yes.
than that.
Even yesterday, late in the day, the trend for this particular storm system was to have that accumulating snow a little farther south. So we're really not expecting a whole lot to add up here in the Miami Valley, but there is still the potential to see some light snow out there. And with temperatures in the 20s, just be aware that things could get slick in a few spots. Right now it's 28. We're just cloudy in Dayton. By noon, we'll be up to 34. And the threat of any snow showers will be ending. Looks dry for the afternoon. We'll be into the upper 30s between 3 and 5 o'clock, 38 degrees, and not too breezy at all today. But here's a check of live Doppler 2HD radar. We do have some flurries, light snow showers, Springboro down through Middletown, even potentially up into southern Preble, Montgomery, and Greene counties. And then across our northern counties, we've consistently had returns showing up here, but we're not getting a whole lot of ground truth reports. Had reports from Shelby County into Dark County, really nothing making it to the ground from Fort Loramie over to the Versailles area. So you may see a few snowflakes, but probably not a whole lot out there this morning. And this system will continue to roll through and be east of us by this afternoon. So our weather headlines, morning flurries, maybe a light snow shower, little to no accumulation expected. Now rain is going to develop tomorrow afternoon, probably after 2 o'clock or so. And then we're going to get into some thunder. There's a potential for some heavier downpours. Windy conditions develop late Saturday. And then we'll dry out on Sunday, but it's still going to be windy and we'll start to turn a little bit cooler. Right now it's 28 degrees. We've got an east breeze at 7. Makes it feel like 21, but much warmer than we've been throughout the week. A check of future track has a lot of dry weather from Dayton northward across the far south. Still the potential of a few flurries or light snow showers through about mid-morning. At lunchtime, we're dry. We're looking cloudy at noon and for the drive home at 5. Nice and quiet. Just some clouds are going to be lingering. Overnight, we don't have to worry about any additional snow showers. Tomorrow morning, we'll start dry. And it really even looks dry through lunchtime tomorrow. But take a look at noon. Back across central and southern Indiana, we'll start to see some rain. That will spread into the Miami Valley after 2 o'clock or so. And you can really see some widespread rain, some heavy downpours coming through. Heading towards the evening, there will even be the potential for some rumbles of thunder. We don't have a huge severe weather risk here. Maybe something isolated gets close to us. But take a look off to our southwest and portions of Tennessee, Arkansas, extending down into Mississippi. It's an enhanced risk, so there could be a severe weather outbreak down that way over the weekend. We'll, again, keep you posted on that. Our wind speed forecast, even though we're not expecting a huge severe weather outbreak here, is going to be increasing. You can see those winds get up there Saturday morning, and then they increase even more going into Saturday afternoon and Saturday night. These will be sustained winds, and gusts could be up around 30, even 35 miles per hour. Today, our high temperature up to 38 after a little morning light snow. It looks like a dry and chilly afternoon. Tonight, we're down to 30, mostly cloudy. And tomorrow, we'll start off dry and pretty quiet. But as we become windy, rain develops, we'll see highs near 54. And then we'll see rain continue to be a possibility Saturday evening into Saturday night. Sunday's dry, windy, and cool with a high of 49. In your Storm Team 2 7-day forecast, Monday and Tuesday will be a little chilly in the 40s, but lots of sunshine, and we will be close to 60 again through the middle part of the week.